In this lesson, I'm going to teach you the technique that is used to find the concentration of unknown acid or base. It is nothing but neutralization reaction that is taking place here. The apparatus used here is, this is called burette, which is a long cylindrical tube which is graduated. Zero is at the top and you can have 50 or 25 centimeter cube, any one of that. And you have a conical flask or Erlenmeyer flask, we need it. And we can have one more burette to measure the exact volume of oxalic acid. Now we are going to use an acid, which is oxalic acid. We are going to use a base, sodium hydroxide. Here we are going to prepare a standard solution of oxalic acid. How do I find out, how do I prepare a standard solution? We are going to use this formula. C is equal to mass, molar mass times volume. So if you want to prepare 0.1 mole per decimeter cube, you are preparing it in 250 centimeter cube flask. Then write down the mass and calculate the molar mass for this substance. If you do that, it is 2 plus 24 plus 4 times 16, which is going to be 64. Add them all together. I think it's going to be 90. So the molar mass, let's substitute 90 here. The volume is 0.250. Then you get the mass of that substance. You can do the calculation and find out what is the mass. Okay, let's use the calculator. See what is it going to be? 0.1 times 90 times 0.25 is equal to, what is the mass that you need? 2.25 grams. So the mass that is needed is 2.25 grams. There are flasks available in the laboratory which is called a standard flask. The standard flask looks like that. It will be like a round bottom one and it is written 250 centimeter cube. And there is a mark there. So what you are supposed to do is you must put your funnel here and transfer the chemical. Oxalic acid is a solid, transfer it. And then wash all the part of this funnel so that everything, all the chemicals are inside. Then you add water up to this, then remove the funnel and shake it nicely. That is going to be the standard solution. What is the concentration of that? 0.1 mole per decimeter cube. So this is a standard solution. That means you know the concentration of this chemical. But now we have got sodium hydroxide, which you don't know the concentration. But we can do this titration technique to find out the concentration of this. What you are supposed to do is you must take the burette, wash it with water first, distilled water. And then after that, you must take that unknown solution, take a little quantity and shake it 2-3 times and drain all the sodium hydroxide. That is called rinsing with sodium hydroxide. The purpose of rinsing is the solution, the concentration of the sodium hydroxide should not change because of the water that you are using. So we rinse it, but in the conical flask we must take 20 centimeter cube from the standard prepared solution that you made, standard solution. 20 centimeter cube you add it, and the indicator we are going to use is phenolphthalein. The phenolphthalein, when you add it to an acid, it will not have any color. But when you add sodium hydroxide into that, the color will change. So what we are going to do is, we are going to use this sodium hydroxide. We are going to allow it to fall into this one. But you have to do it slowly and check. When you add some time, you stir it once. You just shake the conical flask and see whether the pink color is coming. If it is, you must not do it once, you must do it 2-3 times so that you can see what range the end point is coming. Suppose if you are adding 14 ml, the pink color is coming but it takes time to disappear. That means you are nearing the end point. So now you will start adding them drop by drop. So maybe for example, you have got a 16 centimeter cube. When you add 16 centimeter cube of sodium hydroxide into that, the color has changed from colorless to pink. That means that you have reached the end point. When you do first time, you may do one or two mistakes, you may not reach the correct point. Now you know the volume is going to be 16 centimeter cube. Now take the burette, fill it up to zero, and again start doing titration carefully. When you are coming to 15, make sure that your end point is nearing. Then you add drop by drop and find out the exact point at which the color changes from colorless to pink. Repeat the process 3 times so that you can have the correct values and find the average of that and use it for doing calculations. How are we going to do calculations? First of all, you must write equation. So let's write down the equation. What is the equation for this neutralization reaction? We are going to have oxalic acid H2C2O4, which is your acid, reacts with sodium hydroxide. And what's going to be the product? Normally they give the equation, but there are some equations which you are supposed to learn. So better learn to write the equations so that you know what is the molar mass, I mean the mole ratio here. And you have water. And 2 sodium is fine. I think the water, when you do H2H2, I think it's 2 water. Water doesn't even matter. What is going to matter here is the number of moles of acid is 1, number of moles of base is 2. Now, we have got the values of, let's write that down. What is the concentration of the acid? 0.1 mole per decimeter cube. What is the volume of the acid that we have used in the conical flask? 20 centimeter cube. We don't use centimeter cube. We divide that by 1000. So it's 0.02 centimeter cube. Let's go to the base. The number of moles of base is 2. And the volume that we got was 16 centimeter cube, which is 0.016 centimeter cube. Let's assume the average that we got from 3 reading is this one. What we needed to find is the concentration of the base. Before you reach your pH, before you reach your end point, the acid is excess. But after you reach your end point, if you still add the base, your base can be excess. These are all the ones that are used in order to do the calculations. I'm not going to use the formula that you used in grade 11. CaVa over CbVb is equal to Na over Nb. You know how to do that one. But I'm using the other method. What is going to be the number of moles of acid from these 2? Number of moles of acid is CaVa. Or you can even write C times V. It's fine. That is equal to 0.1 times 0.02. Do the calculation. You get 0.002 moles. Okay. The number of moles of acid to number. We are going to use the mole ratio here. What is the mole ratio? Acid is 1 and the base is 2. And the acid value, you transfer that one here. 0.002 divided by number of moles of base is 1 over 2. So when you multiply, number of moles of base becomes 0.004 moles. Okay, what we needed to find out is the concentration. So write NB is equal to C times B. Substitute here. 0.004. What is the concentration? That is the one that we do not know. But we know the volume 0.016. So you can write down C is equal to 0.004. divided by 0.016. Do the calculation and find out what you get here. It's going to be 0.004 divided by 0.016. Let's do this. What is going to be the concentration? 0.25 mole per decimeter. This is how we do the calculations using titration.